Let's turn to guns. I've been talking about this a lot recently, particularly since Sandy Hook, but also before that. You're an independent, politically, in many ways, but what do you make of the gun debate? And I'll tell you why I ask, because in Britain, it's not a political thing. Never has been. It's never been left or right.
Right.
It's more of a human reaction to when these things happen. Right. We've got to do something. Why is it so political in America?
Well, it's a part, I think, of how our country was formed. We did have to take up arms to form our country.
So, well, to get rid of us.
To get rid of, I didn't want to say it, but if you're going to bring it up, yeah, to get you guys out of our hair. So there's that. It's in our Constitution. Look, I own guns. You know, I'm gone a lot. I have a wife. I have two kids. I know how to keep them. They're in a gun safe.
How many do you have? Get them.
I have three.
What types?
I don't have an assault weapon.
Right.
That's true.
So you have handguns, do you?
Exactly.
Right. See, I have.
And I'm a sportsman. You know, and I shoot skeet. And I grew up in the Midwest, so that's a part of my culture. So I understand them in a way that perhaps people living in more urban areas don't have that history.
But I totally understand why you would do that, why you think you have the right to do that under the Second Amendment, and I have total respect for it. You want to defend your family and do some hunting or shooting or whatever it may be. I just don't get the assault weapon thing. I don't get why responsible gun owners in this country aren't rising up together and saying, you know what, they have no place in a civilized society.
Let me ask you this, because I know you've been really leading the charge in this. I haven't heard anyone articulate to me what would really be the problem with an assault weapons ban. We've had it before.
Mm. But you had a kind of woolly ban. It had so many exemptions to it.
Right, and that's the issue. People say,
well, if you leave hundreds of thousands of them still on the streets, it's not a ban. I mean, in Britain, when we had our Sandy Hook at Dunblane, there was a national ban on handguns and assault weapons, and they all got taken away. If you were found with one, you were sent to jail.
So they literally came and took them away.
But this word confiscation causes mass terror
people
in America.
You are
not taking my guns.
Yeah, no, people don't like it. They don't like it. And look, it's a complicated issue. I think one of the problems for me, and I know I've heard you talk about this, and I'm glad, is that I think the mental health, parenting, personal responsibility.
Yeah, so video games. The
first shooter video game stuff, which, look, admittedly, I missed that generationally. So it's not a thing for me. I've never played them. I don't really get it. My kids do. Mm. And I just think kids growing up, blowing people away, blood, pulp everywhere, and then turning it off and going to have a sandwich.
Yeah,
I don't think that is good. And I think that it needs to be a large conversation. It sounds like we're starting to have it as a nation, and that can only be good.
But as a gun owner, you would have no problem if President Obama said, I really want to push for these assault rifles in particular to be taken out of circulation.
Look, I wouldn't, because I like guns, and I don't want to own an assault rifle. I wouldn't know what to do with one. I wouldn't know why I would want one. I also see that if you're a law-abiding person and you bought it under the law, having it taken from you, I can see why people would have a problem with that. But if they don't do that, as you point out, it's not really a ban, is it?
No.
I'm no social anthropologist, but I do think that the last thing viewers want is another Hollywood actor telling them anything about guns, pro or con.